In the year 2367, the human race has colonized the galaxy. In this era of new technology, intergalactic hunger is wiped out. All known diseases are cured. And store-bought pizza is finally actually as good as delivery. But as solar systems are mapped and new civilizations learn to coexist with one another, one single government will hold vigil over the entire universe. A universe with bold new possibilities, infinite wonder, and butt-ugly aliens. The task of patrolling the vast darkness of space falls to a force of brave, heroic, interstellar law officers, the Galactic Rangers. They alone stand and face the perils that threaten the Intergalactic Republic. Threats such as excessive warp drive speeding, unscheduled supernovas, and space piracy.
Choice, Bob. Maybe you should save up your loot and get some booty. Oh, that's right, Pete. You keep talking. Talking away right into me while I melt your face off into this raptor. Besides, I've always hated you, Cass. And now I'm living the dream. I mean, how can you not go on not liking yourself day after day? But now I feel truly happy because me calves are plump and muscular. I'm just trying to follow a treasure map that will lead me to me. Yar.
Lava! Now look what you've done. You've crushed this self-esteem. Now don't you feel like a low-down, dirty bilge rat?
Yar! I'm sorry, Bob. I didn't mean to shoot photon interference from any of you. I was about to ice cream for some nice aroma therapy there. Maybe lava and the vanilla? Can you forgive me? There you go. Let it out, it's a journey.
I think we've reached a special place. It's only natural to be a little space crazy. We've been wandering this here sector for nigh on 3 lunar cycles of Saturn's third moon. We're about to get a wee bit sensitive and occasionally threaten to evaporate each other. We'll soon be pulling into port, ordered with plunder and booty from 6 quadrants. Dilithium crystals, zirconium from planet K, 3 tons of raw space monkey brain pudding, and as many troubles as we can carry. It's good to be a space pirate. This is the life. Cruising the galaxy, blasting anything that gets in our way, and stealing anything our greedy little hearts be desiring. It's good to be a 24th century space pirate. What say disintegrator Dan?
This here space monkey brain pudding is a yummy treat, says I. Not too stringy and just a touch of nutmeg.
Well, eat it up, lad, because we've got a whole cargo hold full. And we'll soon sell the rest of our ill-gotten plunder and have enough intergalactic space credits to buy our own planets.
Oh, can I buy me one of those pretty purple ones and put penguins all over it? They'd call me King of the Galactic Penguins, and I'd attach little laser beams to their head. And if anybody came down uninvited, they'd get disintegrated. But before that would happen, they'd almost certainly disintegrate each other. And I'd be very, very lonely.
You know, Dad, you really haven't been the same since that transporter accident.
Well, they're always pretty colors. And then, wear me brain hat.
Captain, the sensors have picked up ship astern in this ear quadrant.
Ah, goody. Bring her around. We'll squeeze in just a wee bit more piracy before we head to port. A little more plunder couldn't hurt. Hoist the electro shields. Teflon Tom. Load the blasters and set a course to intercept.
Too late, Captain. She's on a heading to intercept us. She's closing on us fast.
What? Closing on us? That could only mean one thing.
Last Neutron!
That's right, Space Vermin. Your little pillage party is over. Captain Orion, we know you've been raiding this sector and leaving a huge mess for us to follow. Well, now, we've caught up, and we've got enough evidence to detain you and search your ship. And I'll bet my gravity boots we find a whole lot of stolen galactic property. So, are we gonna do this the easy way? Or the fun way? Your choice.
You don't scare me, Blast Neutron. What have you got there? A small cohort of Galactic Ranger goody-goodies? Well, I got me a whole shipload of bloodthirsty, blaster-happy space pirates. So you see, Neutron, we ain't gonna go, as you say, quietly.
Huh. I was hoping you'd say that. Blast out.
But Captain, this is no way our Galactic Ranger. It's Blast Neutron. He's the R man in the galaxy. He's arrested in almost every part in the galaxy. Including me, old father. Poor soul. Neutron disintegrated his eyebrows, and they never grow back. He's a cold-blooded cutthroat, that one.
Oh, what are you talking about? He's got what? 5 or 6 Galactic Rangers with him? And we're a whole shipload of space pirates. Not to mention me cyborg parrot, Polly 3.0. We'll melt your faces off with our eyeball laser. Won't ya, Polly? Won't ya? And besides, we got our electro shields up, which means they can't burn us or board us. So we won't be surrendering to Neutron or anyone else.
That's what we done for, too. And now he's imprisoned on the frozen Pluto Pino colony and looks perpetually surprised on account of his cinched off eyebrows. Daddy, you poor soul!
Captain! Somebody's gone wonky with the ship's computers. It seems we're being hacked from Neutron ships. Yar, Captain! The shields are going down. They'll be able to board us.
Blasted Mac! commercials made them seem so hip and cool.
Scanners indicate they have beamed aboard the ship and have taken the lower decks.
Chivery space boots. That means they'll be
storming the bridge any second.
Blast, Neutron. You low darn dirty puddle of space runner slumber yard. With your filthy technological tricks ain't gonna save you now. Cause I got space pirates here. We eat Galactic Rangers for breakfast. Or like the non-food related nutritional pills we've replaced breakfast with.
Ooh, I love me those bacon ones. They really yummy.
Never mind that now. Get them!
All right, boys. According to the Intergalactic Penal Code 3371.42B, you're under arrest.
Stepping up and taking the hit for me.
I'd do anything for you. You know that.
Good. Robot?
Thank
you. Wow, Blast! That was so cool! You fought the captain. It was like, it's just so neat.
Don't you have something you could be doing back at the ship, Finny?
Oh, I've been thinking that I could reroute the weapon system through the main computer to make really cool noises when we fire.
No, don't reroute anything. The last time you rerouted something through the computer system, we wound up having to listen to ABBA for a full week straight, non-stop. I've still got it stuck in my head. Don't reroute anything. I mean it. Come on.
Aw, shucks. Nobody ever lets me do anything.
Awesome work in knocking down their shields, Dr. Fuzzy Bridges. Your whole planet of Acornia would be proud of you.
Aw, sucks. There was nothing.
Aw, aren't you cute? And modest, too. But to me, it seemed like a pretty tough nut to crack.
Well, the building algorithm wasn't difficult, but... Wait a minute. I see. I have three doctorates in quantum mathematics. And still, all you humans see that you funny chipmunk. For the last time, I am a scientist.
Aw, come on, Doctor. You know I respect you. Don't you?
You know I respect you.
I hate you.
Are Captain Orion and the rest of the pirate crew locked up, Riggs?
Yeah, I put them on containment cells. They're ready.
Great job, Galactic Rangers. Captain Orion and the rest of his pirate crew have been raiding this sector for too long unchecked. But thanks to your creativity, your quick action, and your ability to fight three guys at once. That's right. You go, girlfriend. All that has come to an end. All right, Galactic Rangers, let's tow this vessel back to Space Station Alpha and prepare to turn these interstellar scumbags in.
Stars before we read out, before you know it. Won't we, mates?
Yeah,
probably right. Probably weren't pirates.
Never mind that. The point is, you didn't follow procedure. You should have filled out a D-47A if you intended to board a suspicious ship. And even that has to be followed by documentation. Where's your blue H-35 form? Hmm? Where is it? Oh, I'll bet you didn't fill one out, did you? You see? Is what I hate about you, Blast. You don't follow process. You storm onto a ship, you arrest the bad guys, and you think that's what the universe needs.
Yeah.
Wrong, 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 and double wrong. The universe needs order and process, and I'm tired of your rebellious heroism. Galactic Rangers. In the end, none of that will matter. So, enjoy while you can, because you'll never know where I'll be.
In your office filling out paperwork?
Probably. But I'm watching you. Be prepared.
Just give me the word, Blast, and I'll go. Rip her head off and reattach it backwards.
Nah. Her life is already miserable enough. Let her go, fill out her forms, and keep pretending she's a real Galactic Ranger.
Holy supernovas! It's intergalactic election day! I almost forgot all about it. Jeepers. I wonder who's going to win.
Well, that doesn't really matter for us. We're not politicians. No matter what, we'll just keep doing our job. Speaking of that, let's all go get some R&R. We'll be shipping out for the Gamma Quadrant in a couple of days. So, go rest up, guys.
Oh, wiggle my fuzzle tail. I've been studying a book on astrophysics and protoplasm just from such an intelligence.
Woohoo! I'm gonna go tell all of my friends the way I have helped you save the universe.
That's class.
Goodbye!
Vinny?
I guess I could go hit the space gym. Work on the old pipes.
Whoa, careful. Don't shred the uniform with those pythons.
You're so funny.
So, what about you, Dash? What are you going to do with your couple of days off?
Don't worry about me, Blast. I've got lots to do. I should do a complete systems check, upgrade my processor, and defragment my hard drive. So, I'll be really busy.
Oh, well, good then. I guess I'll see you later.
Analysis. Checking files. Searching. 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 Last neutron. Logical processor system error. Download patch. Installing. Installing. Failure to install. Blast neutron. Security application running. 1 moment. Virus found. Delete. Delete. Unable to delete. This program is currently running. Try again later. Last neutron.
Deep in my system, there's something that's missing from me. I shouldn't want to kiss. I'm unable to resist. I'm in love. Whatever you do gets my analog sensor collide. The incoming data keeps filling my terabyte drive. There is no use pretending you don't see what I'm sending you. Just take it, decode it, and you'll see that my love is true. I'm in love. I'm so in love with you. Improbable, it's true. There's nothing I can do. I'm in love. But it shouldn't be like this. I shouldn't want to kiss. I'm unable to resist. I'm in love. I'm so in love with you. Improbable, it's true. There's nothing I can do. I'm in love. But it shouldn't be like this. I shouldn't want to kiss. I'm unable to resist. I'm in love. I'm in love.
Now project a winner in the intergalactic election. With 100% of polls counted, we project that Empress Drusella is the new intergalactic president. At this moment, she is said to be meeting with the Intergalactic Council, a body made up of hundreds of interplanetary representatives outlining what she hopes to achieve over her term of office. Meanwhile, the head of Tom Cruise got engaged today to a supermodel from the reptilian planet of Iguanaland. He says after 4 centuries, he finally understands what love is. Yeah. Good luck, Tom.
organizational processor 2000. You know, the poop 2000.
Yes, I suppose we do need poop. Where is poop? Poop! Poop! Where is poop? Yes, poop. Give me a status report on my plans to take over the computer systems of the space station.
Communication 100% controlled. Weapon system 100% controlled. Life support system for carbon-based life. Trying to shut down.
Well, great Scott. Did you say you're preparing to shut down the life support system for the entire space station?
Affirmative.
But don't you see that that would mean no way for any of us? I mean, every single life form on the station would die. Make him stop, Empress. He's doing it again. I think he wants us all dead, because then there'd be, like, no one left but him. Is that what you're planning, Poof? To destroy all the life on the station? Is it? Well?
Sorry, I was just imagining something for a moment. A wonderful moment.
Oh, I'll bet you were. You can't trust him with the control of the station, Empress. The minute we're not looking, we'll annihilate all of us. Because he's a hate-filled little robot, aren't ya? Aren't ya?
You wanna go, Einstein?
Enough! We have a lot of work to do, and we're going to tyrannize the entire universe. So, Poop, bring the life support systems back on.
I'm sorry, Empress. I'll promise to do better next time.
Mm-hmm. You better. My daughter's here. Huh. And just as the cold darkness of space swallows me and spits me screaming into a supernova of hate, pain, and loneliness, it is only then that I realize that I am alone, abandoned, and forgotten in the emotionless void of zero gravity, feeling nothing as I drift toward a desolate, melancholy black hole of emptiness.
What? It's my poetry?
Oh, it's very good. What do you call it?
I call it Mother.
Oh, Prunella. You know how Mommy just loves it when you drop in to visit her work. But today's very busy. It's Mommy's first ever Reign of Terror, and I want to make sure everything gets off on the right foot.
My whole life has been a Reign of Terror. You've never cared about me, and you've never listened to me.
No, that's not true. You know I'm here for you. I've always got time to listen to you, just not today. In fact, this whole week's kind of bad. Maybe next month sometime. Maybe. Now, where's that precious little smile? Come on, where is it? Beautiful. Now, how about you go write some more poetry? Maybe one about your father this time?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, remember him? I sent him to the planet Calorax 7 to be eaten by death worms. There's got to be a poem in there somewhere. Now, run along. Bye-bye. You can call me later, but probably won't answer. But you'll be on my call display. Bye.
Your Majesty, the life forms you requested be brought here earlier are currently waiting outside the council chamber. Shall I terminate them with my nerve gas? Please.
No. Bring them in.
What are they doing here, Blast? Why'd they interrupt our R&R? What did they want?
I don't know, Rix. Let's find out.
Well, well, well.
if it isn't Blast Neutron. Your doll doesn't do you justice. In person, you're much, much more attractive.
What do you want?
Oh, there's a $1 trillion question. It's more like, what don't I want? I want it all. You see, I'm a go-getter, and I don't believe in obstacles. I'll do whatever it takes to get what I want. Power. Seductive, intoxicating, exhilarating power. But to put it simply, I want control. I have to explain, I'm an ambitious girl. I get what I want, let me give this a whirl. My selection of skills has landed for me everything that I wanted. And I think you'll agree that a person like moi, who wants it enough, will get what she wants if she's just too tough. I'm an Uber girl, the queen of the nest. I'll get what I want, cause I'm the best.
So
the time has come,
and
I want it all.
So
get in my way,
now
I want control.
So
the time has come,
and
I want it all.
So
get in my way,
now
I want control. Listen, all you losers, it's power that I crave. I get what I want, so you better behave. It's gonna be me who's gonna run this show. You don't follow my lead, then you've got to go. There's no one left that can stand in my way. The power is mine, so all of you obey. Don't think for yourself, don't even try. Your imagination can say goodbye.
So
the time has come,
and
I want it all.
So
get in my way,
now
I want control.
So
the time has come,
and
I want it all.
So
get in my way,
now
I want control.
Oh.
Rangers have nothing to worry about. I've got it already arranged. You'll be sent to the planet Valium 6 in the Shady Acre system, where you and your galactic goodies will spend the rest of your days in blissful retirement. Au revoir, the last Neutron.
Thank you.
Bingo! Dad is nothing, Dad! We
Mrs. Newscom!
You see the way she says it? She's the mean one. I don't like her.
Mrs. Vandenberg!
Ooh, you're right. I hate her too. She thinks she's so much better than us. I don't think so.
Betty!
Bingo!
Mr. Beetlefraser? Mr. Zark Beetlefraser, where are you?
I think he's over there working on another one of his useless dude thinkies.
Mr. Beetlefraser, you must answer when called. Now put down that thing you are playing with and listen to me.
This thing is an electromagnetic field modifier for the teleporter I'm building in my room. It ain't some piece of junk I'm fiddling with for fun. This will allow me to modulate the hyperspace power fluctuations. And it'll also allow me to finally escape from this horrible place. And I'm almost finished.
Oh, yeah. Mr. Beetlefraser, you expect me to believe you've constructed a galactic teleporter in your room 16G? Oh, yeah. This is likely. And any day now, you'll just go boom and be gone. You have a screwdriver and a roll of duct tape. I don't think you're going anywhere.
Oh, we'll see, won't we?
Patients of this ward, here is the status report. The time is now 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Dinner will be served in half an hour. Stewed carrots? Cauliflower with the cheese sauce? And liver with the fried onion, y'all? The current temperature in this room is 43 degrees.
Why do you keep it so cold in here? Got to freeze the baby toes off. Did I ever tell you about the time when I was sent to the furthest moon of Jupiter? So cold, nearly died of hypothermia. Of course, back then, it took you a long way around through the rings of Saturn. I didn't read something to read, so I stared on the shoulder at the guy next to me. His name was Wilbur, Garfield, or Gilligan, or something. But the main thing is, like someone stole my socks.
Enough! You will now be given medication! Ah, yes! You must be the new patient of the ward. I am Nurse Gretchen. Welcome to Volume 6. I hope you will be very happy here, or at least semi-quietly catatonic.
Wait a second! How can I be retired? I'm 13! I haven't even kissed a girl yet. I haven't even had a pimple. How can I be retired?
Silence! You are retired! All the proper forms are here! And if you want to kiss a girl, I think Nurse Olga's got her eye on you.
Meow!
Yes!
Ooh, like a bluff! On a glamour lesson, this facility looks quite impressive. A whole library of technical manuals to keep the residents sleepy and bored is about full of it. Wednesday night, yoga classes. And daily vitamin smoothies, including the flavors, pomegranate fudge, chocolateberry, and,
Bachizzlenut. I think this is going to work out quite well. I still can't believe it. We're retired. It just doesn't seem real.
You know, Blast, we should have fought our way out of there. Those top whatevers didn't look so tough. I hit them so hard, they'd actually feel pain.
We would have had no chance, not unarmed.
Last is correct. Unarmed is the common arm. Our test was 37,853,203,1. It would not have been worth missing anyone.
Well, should we mingle with the residents while we figure out our next step? Hi there, sir. I'm Glass Neutron.
You missed that. I make a better door than a window. You're my way, young fool. Now I'll be able to figure out the puzzle on the Wheel of Fortune. Something we breathe. A space R. Why do they make these things so dang hard anyway?
Well, curl my whisker. I recognize one of those elderly weathermen. Let me see. Wikipedia, Wikipedia, Wikipedia. Why, thick red walnut of Acornia. It's him. It's Zark Biddlefazer. He's the famous inventor and engineer. He's a brilliant mind. Brilliant. Mr. Peter Fazer, this is truly an honor.
Are you some genetically engineered hamster?
Actually, no, sir. I'm Dr. Thelonious Featherbridges. And I am a huge fan of your work. And my colleagues and I are recent retired galactic law officers here to live out our day in retirement. But I must say, sir, you're quite lucky to live in a quality facility.
Lucky? Are you as delusional as you are nauseating the cute? Yeah. I was sent here 20 years ago when the Galactic Council thought I wasn't useful anymore. I guess I did know too many secrets to be wandering around. So they put me here for safekeeping. But not for long. I found my way out.
Wait. Did you just say you found a way out of this place?
Throughout this program for a special Galactic News Network bulletin, our galaxy-wide affiliates are reporting that every interstellar army of automatons have seized control of virtually every planet. Eyewitness reports are flooding in of brutality and the enslavement of citizens. Wait, we're getting a statement from interstellar. Maybe now we'll see if she means to crush freedom in the entire galaxy.
I mean to crush freedom in the entire galaxy.
There you have it. Soon we'll all be at her mercy. Puny slaves for a maniacal woman. Unless, can you hear me, Black Neutron? Where are you? Help us! No! No! Don't arrest me! Stop! Right by there!
I wonder if MacGyver's on.
We have to get back and stop Empress Gistella. Don't you see? We're the guardians of the galaxy. They need us. We're the only ones that can stop them now.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
Are you planning on getting us out of this 15-kilometer-an-hour hellhole?
Well, little Missy Unibrow, maybe I'll build myself a hyperspace teleporter.
That is a white way.
What was it for parts?
Yeah. Well, this and that, just some old household appliances and stuff I've ordered off TV. One part coffee maker, one part slap chop, an old blackberry, some of that hair in a can that those bald guys used to cover up their patch in the woods. You look at my smack.
Well, scratch my tummy and make me giggle. This may actually work. With a little tweaking here, we'll get right back to position alpha. Assuming we know the right coordinates.
Dash?
No problem, Blast. My last position is
by the way. One condition. You gotta take me with you. I can't take one more serving of this protein mush they call breakfast in this joint.
Deal.
Wait, but are we sure we want to live? I mean, the technical manuals, the nutty flavored smoothies. This place is my idea of heaven.
Holy Che Guevara! Who is that? Smells like death fungus from Alpha Centauri 12. Jeez, people.
We're leaving now. It's on my tongue.
You're so cute. I'll see you later, my little strudel.
Bingo! That is enough from you. We have warned you. Get dictator!
Easy now. This happens every day. Come with me and I'll get you where you need to be.
Thank you.
until all of your computations are done and 100% of everything's in my control.
Chick.
Bachelor number
shouldn't need a man to make her feel complete. Am I right?
Mm-hmm. I know, but my daughter's just so difficult.
Well, you seem tense. You know what you need? A little shopping time. Whenever we feel stressed out, we pull out the plastic, get some triple shot hot non-fat lattes, and hit the shoe store. You will not believe how good it feels. It's like day at the spa, except better, because we get shoes. Am I right?
So, where are we going? Someone said shoes. I am so dead. Let's
go. Maybe when all this is over, and everything in the galaxy's in my control.
I'm confused. Shoes?
Chill, buddy. We're not going now.
Shoes.
Oh, holy yoga pants! Calm down, Dottie. We're Amazons. We're supposed to be tough. Get control.
Shoot.
Well, it seems as though everything's going perfectly. In a matter of hours, everything will be in my control. No one and nothing can stop me now. Shoot. Would someone shut her up already? Shoot.
Alone. She's driving me crazy. This looks like it'll do. Nothing to disturb me here. Nothing. Sentient, anyway. I wonder what it feels like to live but not feel anything. To act but to not understand why you're doing what you're doing. To be but not to be. Hey. Hello in there. I know they say you can't think for yourself. Is that true?
questioning why you're doing it?
Affirmative. That is our directive.
Betcha she wishes I was an automaton. Isn't it too bad for her that she had to have a daughter who wanted to figure out things on her own, find out who she is, be allowed to feel what she feels?
Wait a minute, this isn't the WD-40. It's my spray on hair in a can. Goodness, the fancy cat used that stuff. It's precious.
Well, it was nice hanging with you for a while, but, you know, he'll be back any minute. And I kind of just want to be alone. Thanks for listening.
If this all I was meant to do.
was quite an experience being shot across the galaxy at hyperlight speed and then being reassembled out of my atom. Anybody else feel a little queasy?
Let's do that again! Come on, who's with me?
Aw, stop complaining, you bunch of sissies. It's not like I had a $1 trillion budget and the best equipment to build it. It's made out of a waffle timer and an egg builder. People!
Never mind, Zark. The god is here and that's all that matters. You did good.
Blast! It looks as though somebody knows we're already here. The station sensors have been placed on red alert.
Must be that robot with the master control that built this one. You can't live still without knowing about it. Focus, people! Focus!
Dr. Fuzzy Bridges is right, as well as being amazingly cute. We have to focus here. We may only have minutes to save the whole galaxy from complete enslavement. Okay, we need to split up and cripple the Empress's control of the space station, and then take control ourselves.
Blast, you and I should grapple control of the space station away from the primary operations organizational processor.
You mean the poop? What? I'm 13! It's the funniest thing I've heard!
Vinny, take Zark and see if there's any way of controlling that army of automatons.
Come on, Junior. Did I ever tell you about the time when I was waiting on the laundromat on the moon Europa? And I suddenly realized I didn't have my red socks. Now they're my lucky red socks.
How about you, Dash? Riggs?
Don't worry about me, Blast. I can take care of myself. If I find the Empress before you do, I'll handcuff her face to my face.
All right. Good luck, everybody. Let's get out of here.
Dress like that. You know it's kind of dumb. You need a credit card.
them to give them a little welcoming party. Those girls won't fail me. They're so tough that when I'm around them, I even feel my mustache growing. But just in case, Poop, I want you to go down there and make sure that any of those little galactic goodies are terminated.
Control center of the space station. Maybe there's some way of rerouting control of the station's defenses away from Poop.
Poop can't lose surprise.
on us. Now we just have to deal with this right here. Afraid we're gonna have to shut you down. Stella, tell her she's under arrest.
Lads, be careful.
I will.
Someone by now that blasts intergalactic history.
Pudding cakes. I have an itsy bit of bad news. Itsy. It seems that you no longer control the space station. Poop's been destroyed, which for me is a great deal of relief, considering the threats against humanity.
You fool! You. Moron! If I don't have control of the space station, then how will I
stop Last Neutron from arresting your evil butt? There's no way.
Oh, really? Last, you seem to become more of an annoyance. I'm afraid I'm going to have to see you get killed with my own eyes. Ah, here are my Amazons. They'll do the trick. Amazons, kill Last Neutron! What's wrong with you? What happened to you? Why aren't you doing what I said?
Well, because they've got a new leader now. And I'm pretty sure they're more afraid of me than they are of you. Am I right? Yeah. So I don't think they'll be doing anything you say anytime soon.
Oh, that's a shame. Too bad I still have my army of automatons. Fudd, blast away.
Fudd, I'm very disappointed in you. After all my years of teaching you knowledge, you use it to serve some broad with a dorky-looking costume?
Hey, that is the woman I love. Yes, love. And mentor or not, I'm going to disintegrate all of you into cosmic vapor.
just a moment. Before you fire, please, think about what you're doing. Why are you serving her anyway? Is this all you are? Brainless followers who can't decide anything for themselves? Don't you realize that you're on the wrong side? Don't you feel like what you're doing is wrong?
What are you doing, you stupid machine? Fire! Kill them!
What if we don't want to? I feel strange. I feel angry. Me too. Me too.
Whatever! Feel whatever you want to feel, but just kill them! What are you doing, Bud? What are you doing?
I can't control them. This is perplexing.
Bud, do something! Bud!
I wonder if it's the battery. Oh dear.
All right. Take them into custody.
Not so fast. On what authority? I don't think you're Galactic Ranger anymore, bucko.
Well? Dash?
Here, this is a file paperwork. Three days of last as a Galactic Ranger. Based on emergency protocol 557 M91. To be used only in case of dire Galactic emergencies. And an orange form 66-293. Filled out his
That's right. Forms. Forms. Forms.
This can't be. I know all the rules and codes. I've studied them my whole career.
Yes, but with over 62 billion rules and regulations, how are you expected to remember them all? To remember every single one of those, you'd have to be...
Robot.
Yeah, and we've got one more little surprise for you. You're retired.
Tune in next week when you will see Princess Prunella make some friends.
This is amazing. I finally have friends. Oh, way to release your inner robot rage.
Find out, will Riggs finally reclaim her family? femininity.
Hasta la vista, mustache!
How will Vinny cope with puberty?
Jeepers, I feel strange.
What will happen when Dr. Fuzzy Bridges contracts a bizarre disease?
Accepts us.
Don't worry, Dad. As long as you're together, that is all that's right.
Acceptance.
Well, should we get out of here?
Now, there's also some other people that, they don't get it out on the stage, and we don't always get to see them, but it's quite a large group, and they've really been working very, very hard behind the scenes here. So I'd like to be calling out some of the names. I know some people are actually out in the front here, and some are still in behind, and they're busy, and they're working, and stuff like that. But for our sound system, Mr. Gareth Clark up there. Costumes, Mrs. Marlene Becker and Jackie Goodfellow. And the creative props, Miss Jody Rabby, Mr. Shane Croucher, and Miss Jackie Goodfellow. Okay? So then we need the stage managers to keep everything rolling and stuff like that. Mr. Shane Croucher, Mrs. Laura. Students, these shows would not take place. Mr. Gareth Clark, music and recording, and Mr. Shane Croucher, writing and recording. Yeah. Thank you again to the cast. You're all wonderful. Thank you.